Philadelphia Mayor Jim Kenney is our newsmaker. Let's get the inside story. Good morning and welcome to Inside Story. I'm Tamala Edwards. Good morning, Mr. Mayor.
Good morning. How are you?
Always good to have you here.
Thank you.
Let's start talking about this PPA State Auditor's Report. The word damning doesn't begin to cover it. It finds for over 5 years, there was a $77 million hole that came between questionable expenses, uncollected fines, all money that could have gone into the school system. Now, City Council and Governor Wolf say, let's just take the agency back to the city. Well, what else? That seems sort of pale. Can you sue them? Can you do something to claw that money back?
We're examining those options now. However, I mean, Clarina Tolson, who's was our one of our deputy managing directors, who's now over there, has been there for a while, I think has really kind of put the place back on track. Not totally, but a lot of the stuff that the Auditor General was looking at happened in the last administration under Mr. Fennerty, who's a friend of mine. I like him, but they, you know, you can't run a place like that. You can't. This is a public agency, and you need to run it with austerity, and you need to run it with honesty, and that didn't happen. And
do you have lawyers looking at this? Like, can
yes,
you
our,
sue?
Our city, well, I don't know what grounds we'll sue on, but I mean, if we can or not, but the city solicitor's office is looking at it, so we'll see what happens. I'm happy for Auditor General DePasquale doing what he did. I think it may change the game and change the conversation.
Are you ready to take back, now that you've taken back the school board, to take back another big state agency?
Yeah, I mean, they take stuff that where they can make money from. And, we didn't really do that well under the SRC when it comes to increased funding for schools. So we decided that we're masters of our own destiny, and we took it back. And if they want to give it back to us on the parking authority, we'd be happy to take it.
In the end, sometime by next spring, you're going to give us 9 people and say this is your school board. No details are out now. I know there's a lot of work to be done. What can you tell us? People want something.
Well, we're putting together the selection committee now, which will determine, which will review all the potential applicants.
Can you give
applicants.
Us any names on who's on that committee?
Actually, there's no names yet because we don't have the selection committee in place.
Okay.
Selection committee should be in place by hopefully the end of the month, beginning of January. We hope to have 27 names before us by March. And then appoint 9 of those 27. Council will then review them in an open public hearing and ask them about their educational philosophies, their talents.
I'm sure there's somebody out there in the city that you've said, please come forward, I'd love to see you do this.
Well,
can you give us some thoughts on people you'd like to see maybe try for
it? Well, there's a few people in the SRC that have done a wonderful job that we would like to, maybe if they're interested. But you have to understand, this is a full-time, non-paid job, and it's a lot of hours that are necessary to do this. So you're asking a lot from someone who and not paying them. There are at least 3 or 4 on the SRC now that would be good, candidates.
You've gotten a lot of pushback on the idea of you appointing these people rather than electing. Every other district in the state elects their school boards. Why not us?
Well, the charter, the Philadelphia City Charter mandated that the mayor appoint. I think what happens is when you elect someone, you have outside influences now with these independent PACs that are allowed to raise unfettered money to raise the support candidates.
But can't you say that about any race? And
yes,
we still have elections.
But I think our kids need to have some accountability. We need to have accountability to our kids and to our families. The main reason why people leave the city is because
schools.
Of the schools. And if we can fix that, think about all the young families that we could keep in our city that wouldn't have to move to the suburbs of New Jersey because they feel that there's not a good choice for schools in Philly.
So why would it necessarily be better? This is what we had in the 2 years before the SRC came on. Why is going back to that better?
Because I think the accountability needs to be with the mayor's office, whoever the mayor is, and the mayor and city and the school board need to run concurrent terms so that if the schools are not performing well, you can throw out the mayor and you'll throw out the school board at the same time. So in some way, they are actually elected because they're appointed by a person who's elected and responsible for the schools. And we really need to take responsibility for the education of our kids. We keep on waiting for Harrisburg and Washington to do something for us. It's never going to happen.
But do you worry about who comes after you? You and Dr. Hyde have made this a signature issue. You've gotten high marks. But you don't know who comes after you, and they'll have this power.
Well, hopefully people will elect a good mayor the next time, too. And Dr. Height, I mean, I just love him. He's a great image for the city. He's a great image for the school district. The kids like him. They look up to him. And he's a great role model. And he did the hard things. He laid off 4,000 people. Mm-hmm. He closed 26 schools. He had to cut everything everywhere. And now he's finally gotten to a place where he's put everything back.
Right.
And we've gone up 5 points or so in our statewide tests.
Let's talk about another couple of issues quickly. The stop-and-go bill, big fight this week about whether or not beer delis should have the plexiglass or not have their rules changed. I know there's a lot of work to be done. You said you're looking at it till 2021.
Right.
What's your gut, though? What do you think should
happen? My gut is that we really don't need businesses that sell shots through a plexiglass window. I mean, that's or malt liquor. I mean, the a lot of what's happening now is a result of the activities and what goes on around those in those businesses, it's not a restaurant. These are e-licenses. E-licenses on the state liquor control system are restaurants. If you can't sit in a stop and go, if you can't use the bathroom in a stop and go, if all you're doing is buying malt liquor and shots. Open a bar.
So they change, but many of them are saying, fine, we'll take down the plexiglass and change, but we're also going to get a gun.
Yeah, I mean, we're still working out that issue. I mean, what happened was this really came to the fore when they started selling individual shots.
Mm-hmm.
When I was growing up in South Philly, you didn't go into a grocery store and buy a shot. I mean,
right.
It's just not something that you did. And I think that we'll work it out in the end, and we don't want to see anybody hurt on either side.
Right.
But some of these businesses are really areas for trouble.
Speaking of which, really quickly, a crime question. We saw this past week, 3 teenagers arrested for a violent beating of a homeless man in Mayfair. Terrible crime. I feel like on my show, the ages are getting younger and younger of who's getting shot and who's getting arrested. Is something different? Is this on your radar screen? Is a different new problem coming along?
I think part of it has to do with our education system, where it has to also do with our society, where things are accepted and seen by kids that I never saw when I was that age. And I think that these are anomalies. I mean, thankfully, it's not an everyday kind of occurrence. And I don't know the psychology of the 3 young people involved, but you know, someone lost a family member, and apparently, he was a pretty decent guy who wasn't bothering anybody. And it's the sad fact of urban life that we have these kind of things.
Is there something differently the police department needs to be doing? Something people always say, crime is my number one issue.
I think education should be our number one issue, and that will reduce crime. Because if you look at the poverty in our city, it's all related to the lack of access to a good education. If we can get our kids reading in pre-K, reading at grade level by third, graduating at 8th grade, graduating 12th, going to college, going to CTE, getting a good job, we won't have to lock people up or have people rehabilitated from drugs.
And finally, really quickly, are we going to get Amazon, or it's just a fun game to play?
No, I think we're in a good spot. I think logistically we're in a good spot between New York and Washington. I think our cost of living is 23% cheaper than Boston, New York, and Washington. I think we're in the middle of a bunch of fulfillment centers that they have. We have great transportation, great.
Are they
airport.
Telling you anything?
No, they're not. They're very close-lipped, and I love the whole process. But despite the fact whether we get them or whether we don't, we have put our face out there, and we can use our efforts as a template to attract other businesses.
Okay, I could talk to you for another 30 minutes, but they say I have to take a commercial. Okay. Thank you for
coming.
Thank
you, my pleasure.
Please come back soon.
Good to see you. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you, too. We'll be right back to Inside Story.
6ABC's Inside Story is presented by Temple University.